Deep inside every skull, an ancient monster is imprisoned. It cares nothing for survival, only for pure pleasure. In 1953, psychologist James Olds found the key to wake it. By mistake, he implanted an electrode in the wrong spot. The rat became obsessed, returning to that corner repeatedly. Olds realized he had found the brain's reward switch. He installed a lever. One press, one shock. The rat went mad, pressing it thousands of times an hour, ignoring food and sleep, willing to die for the next hit. He became a prisoner, dying for pure intracranial pleasure. Olds proved that this primal drive overrides survival. Years later, Dr. Heath planted electrodes in human brains. Patient B19 reported ecstasy and begged for more shocks. The culprit seemed to be the pleasure molecule, dopamine. We thought addiction was just greed for this pleasure. But in 1997, Wolfram Schultz exposed this lie. He monitored a monkey's brain when it received juice. Dopamine spiked at the signal, not the juice itself. If the juice didn't come, dopamine crashed instantly. Dopamine isn't pleasure. It is the language of prediction. It is not a hedonist, but a strict teacher of survival. Scientist Berridge found two systems, liking and wanting. Dopamine fuels wanting. Opioids fuel liking. Addiction is a vicious split between these two systems. Addicts crave insanely, even when they no longer enjoy it. Every like, every scroll is a microdose of dopamine. We are trapped in an infinite loop of wanting, yet we rarely feel true liking or satisfaction. Is escape possible from this biological rebellion? In 1981, Bruce Alexander built Rat Park. It had toys, friends, food, and freedom. Rats in the park ignored the drugged water. Unlike the lonely caged rats, they chose connection. Vietnam War soldiers proved this on a human scale. Upon returning home, 90% quit heroin without rehab. Addiction is about environment and social connection. It is a symptom of loneliness, trauma, and despair. Yet we obsess over detoxes and willpower hacks. We blame the individual's broken brain. This ignores that society itself is a Skinner box. Meaningless work and isolation are the bars of our cage. Consumerism manufactures endless wanting. Are we all just rats in solitary confinement? The fight isn't just internal, it's about our world. Liberation requires a social revolution. We must stop building invisible prisons and rebuild a human park that nourishes meaning.